million. Kids just want their iPod, their cell phone, their car, their fashionable clothes, and they're happy. The real punks were poor and actually cared about the state of things, politically and socially. Fuck the pussies, fuck the pussies, fuck the pussycat dolls. Fuck the pussies, and fuck the pussycat dolls. Kids today don't care about anything real or important. Just buy them stuff and they're happy. Aren't you bored yet? That's why punk is dead. Sex was the words real punks get though. Tell you that, especially Sid and Johnny, Miss Satin 3. Fuck the pussies, fuck the pussies, and fuck the pussycat dolls. Fuck the pussies, fuck the pussies, and fuck the pussycat dolls. Fuck the pussies, fuck the pussies, and fuck the pussycat dolls. Fuck the pussies, fuck the pussies, and fuck the pussycat dolls. Dolls.
This is Mr. Insane with the Insane Show, and I'm here with Barb Wire Dolls from actually LA, kind of, but from Greece. A long way away.
Yes, a long way away.
And can you tell me how life was in Greece?
In Greece, as you see in the news, it's pretty crazy. But we're from the island of Crete. Which is very different than the south, and there's never, you know, there's like no punk shows, and we started an artist commune called the Icarus, and we started because we really wanted just to have some fun and shake things up, but we couldn't even get any shows in Crete, so we had to go to Athens to get shows where there's a bigger scene and real bands, and then we moved to LA for a while, so...
So how did everybody in the band meet? I know it's probably you two first,
yeah.
And then Krash, but now you got JJ in the band.
Yeah, we just Isis was at the commune, so was I. And long story short, she was hearing all the artists write their songs. You know, all the members from Group Love were there before they became Group Love. Vloggy Molly's been there, Jello Biafra's been there, guy from My Money Jacket, and she just liked being around these artists, and one day, we watched The Song Remains the Same by Zeppelin, and after, she asked me to watch it again and again, we watched it 3 times in a row till dawn. She said, "That's what I want to do," and I said, "What's that?" She said, "I want to sing." So she asked to start a band, so we started a band. And I said, "What type of band do you want to do?" She said, "Punk rock." You know, and we came up with New York Dolls. We love the New York Dolls and punk rock, so we just called it Barb Wire Dolls. And we met Krash in Greece, in Athens.
Okay.
And he came with us to America.
Cool. The concept behind the video for Fuck the Pussies, which was the first one that I saw from you.
Fuck the Pussies song, our friend Matt Wesson and John Taylor, our surfer friends of mine, they're like, they called us one night, "Hey, let's do a music video." And Voodoo, who played with us before, found this bunker where he had a place. It was a World War II bunker, and it hadn't been opened. There was paper, there was magazines from the World War II, cans of food. It was literally shut, like after the war, you know. Actually, it was during probably the Cold War, probably during the missile crisis, probably during JFK. Right. There were paper stuff in the 40s, and the walls were disgusting, and we just went and spray-painted all the bands that inspired us. We put a few little signals in there, but a lot of people don't get them. But, and we just did it one night and just had some fun, and they made the video, so that was about it.
Can you talk about Revolution, the concept behind it, with Isis on the toilet, and the message behind the song, Was it just something you were fooling around with and then you decided, hey, this is going to make a cool video?
Well, I guess the song was out and it started getting played on radio in South America. And it actually had reached number one in Brazil on commercial radio and number seven, I guess, in or somewhere top in Peru somewhere. I don't know where. And we had no video for it because, you know, and we were stuck in Florida for 2 months there. And so after a show at FUBAR, we came home. We're like, man, we got to make a music video. All we have is this little camera. And so we said, let's try this idea. And we went to our little bathroom and just did it with one take. And the message is, you know, if you watch the ending of the message and you know what the song's about,
right?
It's pretty obvious what it's all about. And I think, John Holmstrom from Punk Magazine, the original Punk Magazine, said it was the most brilliant music video he's seen in a decade. So I'm glad that some people get the brilliance of it. We thought it was fun to do.
Right. And I always thought the end with the toilet flushing was pretty much the world going down the toilet. Yes. So that was cool. How did Rodney Bingenheimer discover you guys? Did somebody send him stuff about you?
It's a real funny story. We were literally so broke that we were living off of like a $200 a month. because we lost all our money in a festival we put on with 10 bands because of the crisis. And we were in Athens, and there was a store that was selling used DVDs, and we found this DVD, Mayor of Sunset Strip. Hey, let's look, watch this. And we said, wow, wouldn't that be great if he played our music? We just recorded our first album. And 2 weeks later, we get a call from his assistant, Cindy Kona, who says, oh, Rodney would like you to send your album to him at K-Rock. And we did. And then he asked us to call us. So Isis called him on the radio, and he plays for the first time. And he invited us to L.A. to play a L.A. K-Rock show. And so we took the chance. We sold everything we had and went to L.A. for that show. And history is that we sold out the Roxy, our debut show in America. Rodney introduced us to the crowd, so it was great.
Right. How would you say the reception has been for you here in the U.S. as well as around the world? I mean, you guys have been touring a long time. Probably one of the most active bands I know.
I don't know any other band that doesn't have a record label or a PR firm or any backer and has played over 700 shows in 5 years in 22 countries. So yeah, we do it out of necessity and out of the love of music and out of the disgustedness of we have of the music scene. We're really bored with everything, and there's very few bands out there that are doing it that are new. So we're just happy to be out there playing all over the world wherever we can. Thanks to people like you who support us. We're not paying you, right?
Huh?
We're not paying you, right?
No, no, see, nobody pays
you
me.
You do it out of this love.
That actually cost me money.
Yes, I know. You do it. You flew in here and you did everything.
Thank you. L.A., the video for that was actually shot in New York City starting from St. Mark's Hotel on St. Mark's Place.
Yeah, the song L.A. is our perspective on the L.A. music scene after being there a year and being really disgusted with the East Side hippies that were playing non-rock and roll, and how the Sunset Strip was getting a little, too many people were coming out wanting to sign us, record companies, and wanting to, they want to fuck the singer, or someone wanted to sleep with this person, sleep with that person, or, do us some sexual favors and maybe we'll help you. And essentially just told them all to fuck off, the music's strong enough on its own. And we're like, let's do the music video on the Sunset Strip. But we're like, it doesn't deserve it. The song is about, the real music that started out, which started out in CBGBs.
Right.
And the LA punk scene was amazing, but they had blackballed punk for decades on the Sunset Strip until we came back. And so we did it from St. Mark's, where the punks would hang out and they would go to the CBs and go crazy, and that would inspire the world. And so it was a one take also again. Just done by us, just one take, and it worked out, and I think it's fucking badass, too. Thanks for liking it.
Yeah, it is cool. My question is Isis singing during it, or is she just lip-syncing?
She's just listening to the song in her head and singing it.
I was curious, because I seen people looking at her. Like, what the hell's going on?
She was singing
here?
Out loud, because she can't break it, just like, yeah.
I was wondering about that.
And she was wearing no panties, either.
That I did not know. guys have had a lot of media coverage. You want to go over some of the bigger things or more recent things?
I don't know. I mean, there's people write what they want to write, and they do it because we don't pay them. We don't have a PR firm, so we're really grateful that those people say, fuck, I want to write something about this. And even if they're not being pitched by a PR firm, they still write about us. We had Rolling Stone photographer come and shoot photos for us. And it's for the love of music.
Yeah, right. So how's life been on the road? You guys have been touring for years, like I said before. I hadn't seen you in 2 years back. I saw you at South by Southwest for the first time, saw a couple of shows there. Then I kind of helped bring you to Houston through John and BFE, and then you guys have just been everywhere now. How do you cope with always being on the road?
I guess
any crazy stories?
There are some crazy stories, but sometimes some shows are more wild than the others. Some are you know, depends on the crowd, but. Yeah, Texas has been a fun place for us. Houston was fun. San Antonio was a little wild. We got an emergency alert for flash flooding. Right now we're in...
Yeah, if you hear the rain, we're in Texas, so, you know, this is Dallas.
Yeah, it's crazy, but...
It'll downpour and then it'll stop.
We're Greek. We're warriors. And a lot of you people here in America, since you Texans, you know what it means to be a warrior.
Right.
And that's what you got to be in this world.
So your escape was filmed kind of like a live video, yeah. If I remember correctly. Where was that filmed? And
that was filmed in Columbus, Ohio at the Shrunken Head. Ian Powell had shot some footage of us on video, and we asked him, hey, can we use some of that footage and, you know, put some stuff together? And he said, yeah. And he helped us out with it. And it kind of starts off at the beginning of the live with her saying, you know, what the fuck is up with you? You know, you better get your fucking punk asses ready because, you know, Jello's coming up too. That was another song from our video, from our album that we didn't have a video. So we just did it ourselves once again.
Awesome.
A few more edits, though, this time.
you met on the road because of the band that you never thought you would meet?
Well, I'm speaking for us right now, but having Glenn Matlock be there at our show, Sex Pistols, Steve Jones for the Sex Pistols. I mean, everybody, you name it, from Lemmy to Steven Tyler from Aerosmith.
I know you met Lemmy.
Yeah, Blondie, Glenn Berg, Millie from Creator. I mean, who would have thought that? The Millie from Creator is a fan of the band and supports the band. I think apart from having all the people come out and support you and check out the new band, getting the respect from the legends, the original seeds, has to be the highest accolade we've ever gotten. And we don't pay them either, so.
Right. Concept for Shut Up Slut. What is the song about? And the video. I'm trying to remember if it was live or not.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, it was live at the legendary 100 Club.
Yeah, that was our goal was we wouldn't play London until we could play the 100 Club. 100 Club is the most legendary venue there that exists.
Here comes the rain again.
Here comes the rain again. Rhythmics are everywhere. We played there, and it was like all the punks that were coming to see us were walking down the stairs saying, we haven't been here in over 22 decades, This place used to book punk, and it was a legendary place that we had a great show. And Cassandra Powell, who's a friend of ours from Greece, who lived in London at the time, was there. I think she's there. She just filmed us and put together that video, and it's, she didn't even know what song she was doing it for. She just did it. So there really isn't a concept. It's just Cassandra Powell doing her thing, but she's a great video maker. We just did it on the fly and just had some fun. But there's a video of Shut Up Slut live in New York City.
Right, at the Bowery.
At the R Bar in the Bowery. That's a little more what the song's about. It's like her attitude is right there saying, shut up, slut. It's a little more power in that one, but it's not a music video.
What would you say is the state of the music industry right now.
I don't want to puke in front of you right now, but... all I know is there's one good thing, is that traveling across America, 3 years ago, there were like no radio stations worth listening to. There's about one new rock radio station in every city, and they're playing a little bit more stuff, but it's about as dead as it's ever been in the last 30 years.
Right.
And I know there's a huge underground coming up. We're one of those bands that's coming up, and we're giving a big fuck you to the mainstream world that has not allowed any hard rock, especially with Girlfriend. They're very prejudiced against having a girl in a punk band sing. That's why there's been no Girlfriend in a punk band in over a decade anywhere in the masses. It's a very chauvinistic world, but we don't care. We do our thing, and things are changing. Right now, people are bored with anything that doesn't rock. I mean, that's why all the headliners are bands from 10 years ago or 20 years ago. There's nothing new out there.
Very true, very true. And one good thing about the current music industry is actually technology. Yeah. And the fact that it's put the power into your hands, and even me, my TV show, it's online.
Yeah.
A lot of radio stations are online. They're playing the stuff people want to hear, yeah. not what the record companies are paying the radio stations to play. So
it's so important what you're doing. That social media and that internet, you go record stuff. I mean, that's how we got discovered by Rodney. I mean, we put up a MySpace, you know? Who would have thought that someone would look at that from a little band from Crete when we had no fans? We just started out. Yet the biggest DJ in American history, as far as discovering new bands, found us and changed our fate. One person. So, yeah. Rocking.
Right. Teenage Crisis was filmed at the Marquee in Norwich, England. What's the message behind the song and the video?
Yeah, the message behind this song is whatever age you are, you got to go through hell to get to heaven. And that song is about being right there in the line where you're either going to fucking give up, commit suicide, you know, at the worst, or that's when you're going to take the leap of faith and say, I'm changing my life. And when you do change your life, you want to share it with the people. And the one thing about that video is that was the night that ISIS got, by accident, a fan picked her up from the station. She fell off and really hurt herself badly. It was a very dangerous thing. It was in the hospital. And we missed Mick Jones' party from the Clash because he was in the hospital. That was a bummer. We wanted to meet him.
I dropped ISIS once, too.
Yeah.
At South by Southwest 2012.
Oh, yeah.
She jumped off at Red Eye Fly, scared the shit out of me. I wasn't expecting it, and then down she goes.
She does that a lot, and so that was the one time. But the one thing about that video I must say is that I had a very clear anti-Nazi sticker on it with a very clear red line, but it's a black and white video, and I guess it doesn't show, and so I just want to make it clear it's an anti-Nazi sticker, and we're all about positive mental attitude and love.
There are no Nazis in Barb Wire Dolls, just for the record. We'll be right back. So Devil's Full Moon. I know there's a story behind this because I know you guys were stuck in Deming for a while when your touring vehicle broke down. And I know that's when you shot that video, and I know where it is.
We got stuck for 3 months in New Mexico, thanks to a fan who gave us a house, and another fan, Gabe, who gave us this place to rehearse. But most of the songs of Slip were written in New Mexico because we had so much time to write songs and rehearse because we were stuck there, and we were playing every week at the Starmax and other places. But on the Devil's Full Moon, the Mexican people there told us don't go out this night because it's a very dangerous moon, the Devil's Full Moon. And this is where Charles Manson, if he gets out of jail, wanted to live in this town of Deming. And there's some scary stuff there. And so that song was inspired by what we were going through and what we were around the people. And a lot of other things, which you don't have to go into, but it's an exorcism. Writing that song, performing it, released the negativity from us. And it opened up a new chapter of positive flow for us. So it's a very powerful video because it was filmed at City of Rocks and at Faywood Hot Springs, which is right next to it.
Right.
Which is a very, just a mystical place, City of Rocks. 1,000 years ago, people lived there. And 1,000 years ago, there was a tribe living there. City of Rocks in New Mexico. It's amazing.
Thank you.
World on Fire, the video concept behind the song itself. It was filmed in Athens, Greece, so it was real nice to see you guys film a video in Greece.
That was our first return to Greece after being gone for almost, I think, 2.5 years. We came to America, and we didn't have the money to go back, so we just kept touring and touring and touring and touring and touring, and we got stuck, four months in Ohio, 3 months in New Mexico, 2 months in Florida, 1 month in New York, 1 month in Charleston. And so we finally made it back to Greece, and we were so disgusted with what was going on in Greece. That's part of the song World on Fire, but it's not just about Greece, it's about everything. I mean, Slash, you know, I guess likes the song so much he named his album that. So thank you, Slash, for naming your album World on Fire. But that was filmed by Chris I call him Zorba the Dude. But he's a filmmaker in Greece, a very successful filmmaker. And he offered to do that for us on Super 8. And he put in some great footage. That's an amazing video. That right there, to me, is a piece of art. I mean, a lot of the videos, to me, are art. But that one has the classic touches of a piece of art.
Everything you do is art. Music, thank videos, you. And all that stuff. So
art is inspiration.
It's all creativity, so...
Now the world
fight, not war. We are champions. Who's in the video? The guy in the video? I think I saw him here.
Yeah.
Did I see him here? And the message?
Well, he just surprised us. He just flew in from L.A. to see us because he misses us. His name is Sir Don. He's a big patron of the arts. He supports bands. He supports Bad Cop, Bad Cop. That's how we found out about him, because Bad Cop had opened up for us, and we met him there. And he gave us his rehearsal place to rehearse in San Pedro as a gift. And he just keeps coming to our shows and doing everything for us, cooking for us. And we did this song, Mate Right Now War. He's his favorite song at the time. And I don't know, we just came up with the idea. He comes, you know, he goes in that room and he just waits for us to show up to rehearse and go crazy with us. And so, like, what happens if there was, like, a secret camera and, you know, and he's smoking a bowl and going a little haywire? And he starts envisioning, because he misses us, and that's why he flew in tonight to see us.
Very
and
cool.
So, yeah, it's pretty self-explanatory, but it was done, of course, you know, just low budget, like ourselves, just editing ourselves. Krash does all the editing and filming. And, yeah, so it's a piece of art. Why not?
To go into some of your releases. Some of these you might not consider official releases. I know you guys had your first EP out, Puck the Pussies, and then you guys came out with Fuck the Pussies, which was a longer one. Great CD. I know both of those would totally do it yourself. If you want to talk about those, and then we can go into some of the newer stuff.
Yeah. Yeah, we keep doing things DIY, so we print up a lot of CDs. We put them on the internet for a while on digital, and then we're like, we're bored with it, and so we once they sell out the CDs, we take it down, and even though those are good songs on those albums, you know, we did live at the Viper Room too, and that's sold out, and we stopped that. But when we did Slid with Albini, we were like, this is a keeper.
Right.
This is going to be our official debut, and we're going to make sure that it gets out there more. And so, because we have some live albums out right now, too, from Berlin and Paris and
yeah,
stuff.
I was about to mention
but
that.
They're just like there, you know. Slid is like the official debut, but yeah, we released quite a bit of stuff before that.
Was Live in Berlin yourself as well?
Yeah, that was a bootleg, but it was so good that we said, hey, we told the people, hey, can we put it up? And they said, yeah, put it up. You know, once again, they did it for free, and they told us keep whatever money you make from it. So we have three bootlegs out, so that's really nice of the people that have done that.
One of the questions I had was your philosophy on life and pursuing your dreams and the cost and making the jump, because you'll never know if your parachute will ever open if you don't make the jump first. So what's your philosophy on life and pursuing your dreams?
Well, I think I'm just speaking for all of us, especially her right now, but you know there's only one life, but it is eternal, and this is it. And if you don't follow your dream and live your dream and live in the present moment, you're going to wither away and you're not going to be happy. And you got to do what makes you happy. As long as you're not stepping on someone's toes, no one's going to be there to step on your toes. So just do what you love, and you know, and say what you mean what you say, like John Lennon said. I mean, you got the power to do anything you choose, anything. If you believe it's possible, you believe you deserve it, you're worthy of it, and you're not stepping on other people's toes, there's an open road. Everything will conspire to show you the way, and we're living proof. I mean, we came with no money, and the fans have supported us. Our van broke down last week, and we put a post out that, you know, we could really do some with some help, and immediately people sent us money to pay for the costs. They did that to help us record Slit with Albini.
Right.
So we must be giving something out if we're getting so much in return. We thank all the people that support the band, no doubt.
I wanna destroy everything inside.
mind to thank both of you for being here. Isis is not talking. She's a little under the weather or saving her voice for the show. So, and we didn't do introductions. So this is Pyn.
Yeah.
And he's the guitarist for Barb Wire Dolls. This is Isis Queen, of course, vocals, Barb Wire Dolls. Krash is around here somewhere.
Yeah, he's setting
drummer,
up something.
And JJ Doll on bass. Yeah. So thank you very much.
Awesome. Thank you for
thank
having
you very
us.
Much
thanks
for being
for
on
being
the insane
there,
show.
Man.
Appreciate it.
Up the bunks.
Thank you.
Goes by untouched, yeah, by a pride. And tell me, what are we living for? Then tell me, what should we die for? If there's a sign of fire, if there's a soul in flames, if we can get much higher than love, we'll have no name. Then love will have no name. The world is in dire straits. We've lost the war. We've hidden the holy graves. We are living. We're living in shame. All our dead have died in vain. If there's a sign of fire, if there's a soul in flames, if we can get much higher than love, who have no name, then love will have no name. Put your hands together. Move forward. Generation, it can be done. It can be done. It can be done. Oh, love will have no name. We'll have no name. We'll have no name. We'll have no name.